right now, I want to show you one of the most important new features in Photoshop ever. And I don't say that lightly, because we spend so much time making selections. Adobe has updated these selections to make them almost perfect. Now, some images, they work better than others. I'm going to show you three different types of images, and one of them no one else is talking about, and that's working with flat art and line art. And we're also going to be looking at hair and trees. Let's jump in and have a look right now. So first of all, how do we get access to these new tools? Well, you need to be using the Photoshop beta, and you can go under Creative Cloud. Then you're just going to choose apps. Across the top, you'll see beta, and then you'll see the Photoshop beta. Now this will run the same time as the regular version. Notice I have Photoshop beta here, and I have regular Photoshop running at the same time. This is on the Mac, and I've also had it confirmed that this will work on Windows. The next thing we want to do is we want to make sure that we are using cloud processing. So even though we can choose a selection tool and we can choose cloud from here, let me show you how to change it that it will stay there. And this actually applies on both versions of Photoshop. So we're going to go under Photoshop. We're going to choose settings. Then we're going to choose image processing. And this is where we have some different options. Select subject, remove background. You want to change that to cloud and click OK. If you don't have an internet connection, it can automatically detect there's no connection, and it will default to doing it on device. So you won't have any interruption in your selections. Let's go to the current shipping version of Photoshop. And I've also set this one to cloud processing. Okay, so with the taskbar open, why don't we just go ahead and choose select subject. Now Photoshop uses AI to detect the subject in the image. I'm going to pop this on a mask, and at the end of all this, I will show you all of these side by side. Okay, so let's create a new layer mask. And we can see, if we zoom in here, we get the usual problem, webbed fingers. Any of these areas in between are always webbed. It's missed a little bit there, and let's have a look at the hair. Okay, maybe that could be a little bit better. Same with the scarf. Let's look at the same image inside of Photoshop beta with the new selections. And we're going to choose to select subject. Let me pop that on a mask. Notice already this is significantly better. Look at this. We're getting in those tight areas. We don't have the webbed fingers. And when we look at the hair, we can see it's a much better selection. Now, don't forget, there are other tools such as Select a Mask to help us refine the selections. We are just looking at the initial selection here without doing any modifications. Okay, let's have a look at the tree. I know this is something people struggle with, of all these little gaps in here. Because I hear people saying, hey, if you want to get a good selection, just use the pen tool. Okay, good luck using the pen tool on this tree. I'll see you in about a year. Okay, so let's use the select subject once again. It's going to take a moment here. It's going to select the tree. This is in the current version of Photoshop. And now I'm going to create a layer mask. And we can see here, yes, there's some problems here with the blue not getting in between all these gaps. That's pretty much what we would expect. Okay, let's go to the Photoshop beta. Let's grab this tree. Same thing. Let's select subject. Okay, great. Yes, and I could add this bottom part to the selection, but we're just looking at the selections right now. So let's just hit that mask and look at this. Much, much cleaner. It's getting in all these gaps. And before you say, hey, that's a checkerboard, show us against color, I will at the end, I will compare them side by side with different color backgrounds. All right, let's look at one that is going to surprise a lot of people. Now, here's a vector. So remember, these vectors are rasterized now. They're just flattened onto a document. Let's go ahead and we're going to choose select subject. And if we hit the mask, it's pretty much what you would expect. You know, it got some areas, it missed some areas. Not bad around the edges. Pretty good, right? But check this out. This is going to blow your socks off. I'm going to choose the same vector. By the way, it's flattened, just into flattened image here. And we're going to choose select subject. Now watch this. I hit the mask, boom. Now tell me that is not amazing. We go up here, these edges are looking pretty good, but it's got in between all these gaps. Look at this, even these gaps in here, it got in there. All right, so why don't I put these three together so you guys can see? Okay, comparison time. As you can see, it's pretty obvious already, but on the left is existing Photoshop, on the right is the beta. So if we want to look at this maybe against a white background, so I'm not really worried about these little, you know, black edges. That's not an issue because we would use selective mask. What we care about is the quality of the edges. So let's go to 100% magnification. Okay, so at 100% magnification, there's obvious things like the hair, but look, it's even done a pretty good job of the blurred hair. Look at that. And then, you know, when we go to things like the webbing and the fingers, definitely a lot better here. And then what I really care about is also things like the edges. What are the edges like in places like maybe the arms? They're not bad on here either. Okay, when we look at the feet, we can see this is definitely better. And one of the things that always annoys me is when we get this kind of edge. But if we look at this now, this is better. And remember, this is 200%. All right, and then look at things like the hand. Look at the webbing in between the fingers. And look at this one. It's just a little bit there. It's not perfect, but it's certainly going to be a lot easier to fix that. And in fact, select a mask would get all of that. I'll show you in the end what I will do right after these other comparisons. Next one we want to look at is the tree. So if we look at this tree right now, we can see that. Let me put that against a white background. And it's pretty obvious, you know, the quality difference. Like, let's look at this on a black background so you can see. It's a little bit of fringing around there. But compared to this, it's definitely night and day. And decontaminate colors would probably get that, which is what I'm going to show in a moment. All right, let's have a look at one other option. Let's look at against red. Even though in this situation, you know what, we'd probably be looking against blue, be more like a sky. So let's grab something more like a sky blue here. And if we look at that, you know, you can see the result there compared to this one. And of course, we've already got, you know, the whites and the blues kind of showing through there. So that probably makes that one look better. If we revert that back to the red, you can see those edges. And then finally, the vector. Okay, so if we look at the vector here, if we put this against a white, everything looks perfect. So we're not going to use that. We're going to use black. All right, and if we look at the black over here, we can see a lot of these gaps in here were missed. But maybe I thought that was part of the subject, fair enough. But that mouth should have been grabbed and some of these other areas. Look at the loose areas around there. If we look at this, look at that. This is against black. There's barely even a fringe around there. We've got these nice gaps in here in between. And I'm at 200% now. And look at this. This is shockingly good. You know, if I look at this against a color like a red, look at that. Now remember, this is 200%, so this is larger than life. So if we double click, we go to 100%. Look at that. That is pretty close to perfect. And then if we look at the previous version, right there. Okay, I'm going to jump back into beta. And I did mention about getting, you know, areas like these fingers and different things like that. Let me show you. And I'll use select subject once again. Great. Now, what you need to do is you need to grab one of these tools here, any one of these selection tools, and this will bring up select a mask. And now we can pop on there and we show it. Let's turn the transparency all the way up. And why don't we view it against our white? So if we look at this in white and see how we get just a little bit of those fringes, and we're at 160% right now. These can very, very easily be fixed just by taking the contrast slider and just barely giving that a little tweak. See how that'll just get right in there. And as far as these edges, you don't have to worry about those. We go under output settings and then choose decontaminate colors. Watch that edge. Decontaminate colors. Boom. That edge is now really clean. and look in here. There might be a couple of little touch-ups that you need to do, but look at that. The majority of the heavy lifting is going to be done for you. So I've actually been very excited about Select Subject for a long time because it saves me so much time. I've been using Photoshop for over 25 years, and I've spent probably 5 years of my life making selections. Is this going to save us so much time in our selections? Yeah, we have to do just a little bit of tweaking here and there. So for things like solid graphics, flattened vectors, because, you know, a vector is transparent, but this is flattened or rasterized into the image, things like line art, different things like that, it's almost perfect. I got to tell you, I'm really impressed. I'd love to know your comments. Drop a comment underneath and let me know what you think about this. And if you want to know another new feature that's inside the new Photoshop beta right now, check out this video that I just did. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.